I'm Dan, Chief Instructor here at DW Aviation, and today we're going to talk about how to do standardized callouts. I'm mainly making this video for my students here at DW Aviation or other instructor friends who use the same typical standardized callouts, but this is applicable to anybody at any level of flying, private pilot especially, but if you get into the airlines, you're going to become very familiar with callouts. Callouts are great habits to get into because they carry significance in any aircraft that you fly. It really helps with a safety perspective. It helps with crew communication, procedures, following your op specs, things like that. They will change plane to plane based on your SOPs or the POH for that plane or what operation you're doing, but in general aviation, there are a few great tips for callouts. So in a training environment, standardized callouts typically are done by the student as the pilot flying and your instructor is just verifying. The callouts can be verified with a checklist. Checklists can be paper or they can be virtual digital checklists. So on my iPad, I have all this digitized, but again, I also have the paper copies. So if you just see your instructor on the iPad here at DW Aviation, it's because we are verifying your checklists, but we're just making you get in the habit of reading it on paper. So doing the callouts out loud, and especially if you're flying alone, is very, very important because you don't want to get into a situation where you forget something or you're practicing it wrong to where you're not saying it out loud, and then you get in a situation where you should have but didn't and you forget something, right? Like forgetting a fuel pump might not seem like a big deal until it is a big deal. So get in the habit of making these callouts happen on every single flight, every single time there's a trigger for a callout. Do it out loud, whether you're flying with an instructor or alone. It is a good practice to avoid saying the word to, because T-O sounds a whole lot like T-W-O. So for instance, if I'm saying climbing, I call air traffic control and I say 5,000 climbing to 9,000. Well, what air traffic control just heard is maybe I'm climbing to 29,000 feet. And they're gonna scratch their head if we're in a Piper Cherokee. A better way to say this is rather than saying 5,000 to 9,000, let's just say 5,000 climbing 9,000. And that's all you have to do. Standard calls also help maintain situational awareness because, for instance, if you miss your 500-foot call out, your flaps could still be down. You could be climbing with flaps in. More importantly, if you miss your 1,000-foot to climb, 500-foot to climb, 100 feet to climb call out, you might totally forget what altitude you're going to. So the first thing we should do before we get in the aircraft is the passenger briefing. The trigger for that is prior to getting in the aircraft, you tell the passenger how to get in and out of the aircraft. Then once you're seated in the aircraft, you tell them things like it's a no smoking flight, where the emergency exit is, location of survival equipment, how to use seat belts, and then that you will have a three-way positive exchange of controls. Or if they're not going to be flying at all, you just say, if I put my hand up, I'm not being rude, I'm just saying, please stop talking, I need to hear something, or whatever other specific things for your flight. So do that passenger briefing. Next is your engine start sequence, and this is done prior to engine start. So first you visually verify, then call in the cockpit, clear left, clear center, clear right, and I want you to actually do this looking out the window. So clear left, clear center, clear right. Make sure that it's clear, then lean out the window or the door and yell clear prop. So anybody around the airplane hears that as well. Once you get started, you should have memory items that you're doing, like visually verify that your airplane isn't moving, that you're in 1,000 RPM range, and that your oil pressure's in the green. You can make those callouts, then you can turn your avionics on, proceed on course with your checklist, basically. But then once, prior to taxi movement, before you even start moving the airplane to get off the ramp or whatever, do a brake check.
We're gonna go ahead and get rolling, clear left, center, right. Brake check, good brake check.
Once you start moving and you have your clearance, you need to obviously stop before the hold short lines. And once you get that clearance obtained and copied, you read it back to air traffic control, then brief it out loud in the airplane. The call out for this, once this is done, is then again, clear left, clear center, clear right. And you're gonna tell your instructor or other pilot or examiner whether you're turning left or you're turning right and to which runway you're going. And that's the taxi that you just briefed. So once you do that, then you do your run up and then you do your departure briefing. So your departure briefing in the run up pad is the trigger. This is where you talk about any minimum equipment list or deferred items on the aircraft that need to be discussed. The weather and winds, for instance, your runway information, initial heading, initial altitude, any emergency procedures, aircraft briefings about fuel, oil, any other special things, discrepancies, that's all done there.
Ready for departure brief?
Yep. So, taking off, four right. We'll do a right downwind departure. Got a setting head in, we'll go to 2,500. Any emergency, I think we both know. Any emergencies prior to rotation, we'll stop the runway. After, we'll pitch for best glide, which is 73. And after that, if everything goes well, we'll continue to Sky Harbor. So you'll take comms.
Cool.
And we'll just do style as usual.
Okay, there are comms. And we got Phoenix Approach plugged in.
Okay, perfect. Yeah. Anything else from you?
Yeah, if we take that departure heading and altitude, we should be good. Phoenix ATIS is 127.57. So that is backed up. We will go ahead and get that as soon as we're airborne. It's going to happen quick. It's going to be a quick call. So you fly, I'll take comms.
Yep.
Let's get out before this gun. I think we're good to go.
Yep.
When you get on the takeoff roll, so meaning you're turning onto the runway, first thing you should do is a call out that runway number matches heading. Verify that you're taking off on the right runway. And then once you're lined up, you're on center line, and you go full power, you call power set, you check your engine instruments and then verify that they're in the green. So do that, and then once your airspeed starts picking up, call airspeed alive. So that's just when the needle ticks off. And then you can call out your speeds. At, you know, in a Skyhawk, for instance, 55 knots, you'll say 55 knots, rotate. Then once you rotate, if you're in a complex aircraft, you'll call a positive rate, gear up. So once you do all that, you want to call out the next checklist. So basically then your next checklist is your 500 foot climb checklist.
81. And heading matches runway.
Fox Tower Skyhawk 2050.
Power set.
22 left, ready for departure.
Instruments in the green. Airspeed's alive.
So then your 500 foot climb call out is, again, 500 feet AGL, you're just verifying, but it's something you need to do every time. And you verify all that. That's just a four-step call out that you want to check every single time you're at 500 feet.
Sure, gate number Delta, 22 left, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, runway 22 left, 108 number Delta. All right, and verify everything is good. We'll enrich in that a little bit. Lights are all on, clear final. It'll be a right crosswind.
Flaps 59-3, 22 left, clear land.
5,000 feet remaining.
22 left, clear land.
22 left, runway is verified, heels to the floor. Slowly advancing that throttle. Power is set. Engine instruments are in the green. Airspeed is live. Air 60, rotate. We'll do our 500 foot checklist, which is power set, engine instruments in the green, and flaps are up. There is 22 right, got eyes on it. Another about 300 feet to go here. We're gonna start turning our downwind.
Anytime you're doing a positive three-way exchange of controls, that's a trigger to then do that three-way handoff and those callouts. So whoever's flying will say, you have controls. The other person verifies, I have controls. You verify again that you have controls.
And now we're back on course. And your controls whenever you want.
Back control.
Your controls.
So anytime you do a normal checklist and there's a normal checklist out, you want to call out whether you're initiating, you're interrupting, resuming, or completing that checklist. So I'll say, for instance, say we're doing our climb checklist. I'll say climb checklist, power set, engine instruments checked, gear up, flaps up, climb checklist complete. Or if I'm doing my before takeoff, I'll do the before takeoff and I'll say before takeoff to the line complete, before takeoff below the line complete. If you don't know what to the line below the line means, go watch our video about checklist usage. It'll clarify it a little bit. But whatever the checklist is, call out the name of the checklist, call out what you're doing. If you have to restart, call it again. And then a good rule of thumb is call out your next checklist. So your before takeoff check is complete, next checklist is climb checklist. And that'll just kind of get you, you know, thinking about it.
Pitot heat is off, transponder is set to 1200 and on altitude mode.
Proceeded to the runway barrier for runway 22 left.
Transponder is good, and cabin door, both latches are secure, and open window for taxi. And brakes are released. That is our before takeoff check complete. Next thing we're going to do at the line, at the hold short line, is we're going to go ahead and turn all these on. So, now we can go ahead and call for taxi. Information, Mike.
Anytime something is engaged, so anytime you turn on autopilot, anytime you set your altimeter, anytime you get something changing from ATC, maybe you're direct to a fix now, anytime something changes in the airplane, call it out. So altimeter setting, 29 or 87, plug it in, call it out.
Clear through Bravo airspace, I maintain 4,500 and fly heading 190.
Clear through the Bravo, 4,500 heading 190, 10 November Delta, thank you.
UPS 9823, turn left heading 160, maintain 3,000.
Once you're on a cross-country flight plan, when you pass a specific thing outside, whether that's a visual waypoint or a navigational fix, you want to call that out as well. If you're deviating, you want to call out your deviations with whatever that is correcting. This is a great check ride tip as well. If you're in your flight portion and say your altitude is deviating or your heading is deviating, you'll say altitude correcting, heading correcting, speed correcting. Once you do that and you correct it, now say you're getting back into the approach phase. So 10 miles out from the airport is your trigger. That's where you're going to run your approach checklist or whatever your checklist says. Give your approach briefing, whether it's a visual briefing or an instrument briefing. Check your flap setting and make sure that that's appropriate for your aircraft. So for instance, if we're on a 5 mile straight in on Cherokee, 3 miles out, we'll do one notch of flap, so that's 10 degrees. 2 miles out, we'll do 25 degrees flaps, and then 1 mile out, we'll do 40 degrees flaps. So basically 3, 2, 1, and we're notching those flaps in. If you're on downwind to base to final, you're doing your flap settings there as well. 500 feet above the ground. So 500 feet AGL on your landing, you're gonna do the GUMPS checklist, and I have this as G-U-M-P-P-S-S. So two P's, two S's, and that stands for gas, undercarriage, mixture, props, pumps, switches, and then secure. You gotta make sure that you have gas. So fuel selector is both, or left in the detent, right in the detent. Undercarriage, so your gear is down. Mixture is set full rich, or whatever appropriate condition for the flight. Props are set forward. Pumps, fuel pump on, whatever other pumps are on. Switches are all set appropriately. So landing light on, taxi light on, whatever switches should be on are on, whatever switches should be off are off. And then secure, I add this one for cabin secure. Make sure that you verify that the cabin is secured, seat belts are on, things of that nature. And then once you reach 100 feet AGL, you're gonna call either approach is stable, clear to land, runway, whatever, and verify again runway matches compass, or if it's not stable, based on those stable landing criteria, then you're gonna trigger a go around. When you're doing a go around, it's important to note that you don't just have to do that 100 feet on the ground, you can do a go around at any point in time. I've had students do go arounds in the downwind because it doesn't look good, and that's totally fine. That is essentially the standardized call outs. You wanna make sure anytime you're climbing or descending as well that you call out 1,000 feet to climb or 1,000 feet to descent, 500 feet to climb or 500 feet to descent, and then 100 feet to climb or 100 feet to descent. It's also a good practice when you're leveling out somewhere that you call the level out just so the other person that you're flying with knows what you're doing, or that you keep it fresh in your mind and you know where you're going, what the next step is, and where you are in the flight profile at all times. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, go to dwaviation.us.